That's an old reference.
Shiny Nautica.
Drax said, whenever I edit, should I make James's quotes all into a black box form?
Oh, here.
That's old school. Reference
that's
that
old when I was back in school.
Yeah, that's a reference that, like, only Drax, you, and I will get. No one else is going to know what the heck that is even referencing. Hey, everybody, it's Pembroke W. Corgi, and I'm here with
James Irish from Gaming Street Irregulars.
You want to plug your podcast real quick? Like,
you can find Gaming Street Irregulars on Spotify, iTunes, Google Podcasts, and just about anywhere else where podcasts can be found. We are part of the Mighty Monkey Corporation, purveyors of Flower City Comic Con in Rochester, New York.
I was a guest on one episode. I don't know if that's a positive or a negative.
It's an incredible positive as far as I'm concerned, because you get the ball rolling on 5 out of 5 positive guest experiences so far.
Nice. Let's see. Well, hopefully I can keep the ball rolling on what's been going on with these streams lately, which since the RC Pro-Am stream, I have successfully beat every game I have played in stream. So hopefully I can keep that going on too. So today we're playing Shatterhand. Shatterhand is an awesome game. I did not play it as a kid. I didn't play it later until I was older and was like, wow, this game is pretty cool. But I never played it all the way through, so I guess this is a semi-blind playthrough. It's also originally was a Sentai game in Japan that got the graphics completely remade to be something completely different in America. What was the name of the Sentai show again?
Tokyo Shirei Soruberian roughly translates to Super Rescue Soul Brain.
Soul Brain. Let's see. All right, so let's get this started. Yeah, except for now. Oh, I was hitting the wrong button. Dope. Let's see. All right. Look at this, like, Arnold-looking motherfucker here. You got the power of the punch, as Regal would say.
Oh, there's an old-school reference.
I love that, though, with Regal, that, like, routine he had where he had the power of the punch, where it was really, he was, you know, he'd hide the brass knuckles and use them in wrestling, but his claim was it was the power of the punch.
Yeah, that's an old trope in wrestling. I recall reading a story about Kurt Hennig's dad, Larry the Axe Hennig, having hidden a quote-unquote illegal object, and upon closer inspection, a fan would later discover that it was just an old popcorn container. Grab from the concession stand.
The American story for this game is actually kind of hysterical. I'll get to that in a second. I should probably explain what's going on. So in this game, you're fighting some bad guys. I think they're called the Metal Force or something. I don't remember.
Metal Command, General Gus Grover. GGG.
Wow. Let's see. Could be worse. Let's see. It could have been ran by... this is a bad joke, but it's... I have a friend whose name is Kyle... his name is Kyle Condis. And we keep... And for a while, we used to try to convince people that his middle name was Kevin. So... yeah.
Good night, everybody.
Exactly. Let's see. We mostly did it just to get a rise out of him, which, you know, that's what friends tend to do sometimes. All right. Anyways, your guy's got the ability to punch, and that's because he's got metal arms. So you do a lot of punching in this game. You also get these cool robot buddies that I don't... I keep getting the bees, though. I don't remember what does what and which are the best. But you can get some robot buddies to help you out by getting these like Greek symbols, and different connections get you different ones. Oh.
Yeah, right now you got beta, which gives beta alpha. You have Pyrobot, which shoots a long flame, activated by pressing the B button, then pressing and holding the B button a second time to make the flame shoot forward.
Oh, that's actually kind of cool. Did that guy just freaking rifle whip me? That guy, like, hit me with, like, uses rifle like a freaking bat on me. That's kind of awesome.
Well, that's what they're used for, isn't it? That's the Billy and Jimmy Lee logic,
yeah,
as per Double Dragon Neon.
Ah, Double Dragon Neon. I love that game. See, I want a Double Dragon Neon too, dang it.
I'm hoping that Limited Run Games gives us a physical release for the Switch.
That'd be nice.
They've done it with a lot of the other stuff from Way Forward. Well, that was relatively easy.
Well, it was the first level.
True.
The story to this game is kind of hysterical. So seemingly, what was it? You said Metal Command took this.
Oh, yeah, I can read the whole plot right here for you.
Yeah, Metal Command.
In the year 2030, a group of military renegades known as Metal Command, led by General Gus Grover, are seeking to conquer the world by building an army of cyborg soldiers. Steve Herman, a young police officer from the Bronx, ends up losing both of his arms during a skirmish with members of Metal Command. After the incident, Herman is offered two specially developed cybernetic arms developed by the Law and Order Regulatory Division, aka Lord. Oh, Lord. To replace the ones he lost, Herman accepts the offer and becomes an agent codenamed Shatterhand, who is now tasked with the mission to defeat Metal Command.
Wasn't there something like Metal Command took his arms and now he's gonna get them back with... And he's called Shatterhand?
Possibly.
What? See, he's called Shatterhand. You'd think Shatterfist? No. Shatterhand doesn't sound like a good name, though, to be honest. It sounds like your hand is going to shatter. It doesn't sound like you're shattering people with your hands.
Yeah, it's the old disintegrating pistol. Because, brother, when it disintegrates... It disintegrates.
This pretty rocking tune.
Oh, we're going to Pink Floyd's Animals.
Nice. I also have to give this credit for a game that gives you such a short range attack. They still manage to make it feel really powerful, and it doesn't feel like you're at a disadvantage from it.
Yeah, you seem to be punching through that shield okay.
That's what happens.
Or at least not.
When someone takes your arms and you're given robotic arms as a replacement. Oh, shit. Buddy.
Okay, we have an alpha. Now, is there a particular power-up you're looking for?
Not particularly, because I don't remember what any of them are, so I'm kind of just going through to find out what everything is.
We did Pyrobot. That was beta alpha. And we have an alpha to start, so our options include...
Oh my god, Seamus!
Now we're at alpha. If we go alpha, we get Yobobot, which fires a large bouncing ball that retracts like a yo-yo, or alpha beta, which is a laser bot. Fires a laser beam.
Wait, which one is that? Alpha beta?
Alpha beta.
That sounds kind of awesome.
Oh. Shame there's no delta options in here. Then we can make a very easy Saturday Night Live reference. Delta. Can I help you?
I also like that the animation at the third punch is kind of like an overhead, like, haymaker kind of punch. Damn it, I'm gonna die if I keep this up.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see.
Oh!
I like that this guy... I like that I'm so badass I can punch through these, like, giant robots, but then that, like, guy with a gun took, like... Oh, damn it. That guy with a gun took, like, three hits for me to, like, take him out. some robotic arms. All right.
Oh, son of a motherless goat.
Ouch.
It kept you on that screen for a while.
Yeah, that was kind of weird. I was, like, wondering if I had to push something. They're just like, yeah, you know, you just died in the pit. We're just going to let you, like, ruminate on that a bit.
Okay, I'm going to set my mic down so I can quickly interact with the chat a bit.
Let's see here. All right. Oof.
Okay, I'm going to have to occasionally refresh my screen here so that I can keep up with what's going on. So you're on the conveyor belts now?
Yep. Gotta go to the top. Oh, wait. I forgot about the chain link fence I can jump on, which is kind of a neat effect, I might say.
For 8-bit NES? Yeah, that's not bad.
Okay, look, game, you don't have to, like, make me feel bad about my death there like that. Alright, so this game's definitely a challenge, I can say that. Though, seeing all these, like, huge, like, robots does make me think that at some point I need to, like, try and, need to see if I can take on a Journey to Silius sometime.
Greetings and welcome, Super Skulls! So I'm noticing these giant robots don't seem to move any faster or slower on the conveyor belt.
It's almost like they have an advantage. Ooh, there we go. Oh, I like this laser gun.
Just a lot of inertia.
Oh, gosh dang it.
Oh, there you go, laser box!
Ooh, I did not get hit by that. Nice. I'm digging Laserbot right now. Though, Beta one was actually pretty good, too.
I do agree, Skulls. This game is programmed fairly well for sprites, from what I can see. This
game's pretty nice looking. If I remember right, I think this was a program by this game was developed by Natsumi.
Okay.
And was published by Jellico. See, definitely couldn't have been made by Jellico, because I'll be honest with you, this is way too high of a quality for them. which is not exactly hate towards Jellico as much as I often refer to them as kind of the masters of mediocrity.
True, but they did bring us the NES version of one of my all-time favorite computer games, Maniac Mansion.
That's true.
Have you done that on stream yet?
Not yet. It is definitely one of them that I would like to do at some point.
I would greatly enjoy being back for that.
Did you know the Japanese version of that is different?
Yes, I did. Thanks to Crontendo.
Let's see. It is kind of cool that they decide to completely redo it rather than just, you know, port over the pre-existing Famicom version.
Yeah, because I hear that first Famicom version wasn't as hot as it could have been.
Yeah.
I like the graphics style myself, but...
If I remember right, wasn't it done, like, in kind of a weird chibi style?
Yeah. Whoa, they just went Ouroboros on you.
It sure did. Also, nice Strider reference.
Strider.
A high fishy fin theme thing. See, according to Fishy Finn thing in the chat, he says many people say that Grenade and Swordbot are the best. Which one's Swordbot?
Swordbot? Let's see, that's Alpha Beta Alpha.
I'll have to try that one. Ooh. Bombs from the sky, fun. Speaking of Strider.
Oh, no kidding. And that reminds me, I have you booked to appear on the Strider episode of the podcast in March.
Nice. Which one was Swordbot again?
Swordbot is... I'll have to pull it up. Here we go. Alpha, Beta, Alpha.
Okay, so I can't get that right now, but I'm fine with having Laserbot again. No, let me up to... Okay, fine. I won't go get that. I have robot arms, but this simple human, I cannot just beat in a single punch. Ouch. Oh, damn it. I got beta. Because it's alpha, beta, alpha, right? Or is it beta, alpha, right. Beta? Dang, I'm already getting confused.
Yeah, you got Laserbot.
Well, no, I mean, I just got beta as the next one. For the next
okay,
one.
Okay, I think my screen is a little behind you. Because I'm viewing from the Twitch stream right now.
Oh, I forgot to share my screen with you in Discord. Sorry. Let me fix
that. That's okay. We can catch that in a moment.
See, give me 1 second and I'll share that with you. I am a forgetful dragon, if not anything else. All right, you have the...
I can relate at least half of that. The forgetful part, not the dragon.
See, do you have the share screen now? Yes.
I see your continue screen.
All right. I wonder if this game has unlimited continues or not.
Can you still hear me when I'm not holding the microphone directly in my hand?
Yes.
Okay, good. I can type a little more easily.
Let's see here. I'm going... Okay. ABA. Alright. So, I'm going to put in a save state just in case these are not unlimited continues. Granted, I may have also wanted to try a different level. Oh well. Shields? Your shields do nothing to my punches, sir. However, your bombs might. Oof. Alright. Oh, shit! No, I forgot to change it to beta. Damn it.
Okay, so Alpha Alpha, your options are Yobobot and Laserbot again. Wow, there's a lot of lava and fire motifs in this game so far. Or was that first stage we were in Toxic Sludge?
I think that was lava. Let's see.
There's Laser.
And grenades. Excuse my language. Let's see. Alright. Oh, that guy's got like the most relaxing job ever. Gyro chair.
Did he get that off the set of Wall-E?
Let's see. Ah! Got him. See. You still there, James?
I'm still here.
Okay, I heard a sound, so I was afraid you... I lost you for a second. Damn it!
Yeah, I just sent messages to a couple buddies on Facebook to get them to come along if possible.
Awesome. Thank you.
I would have invited Christy, but I imagine she's already asleep right now. Let's see.
This game's quite the challenge. I don't know if I'll be able to keep my winning streak, but who knows? Might just have to be more than one stream. Let's
see. More of this game I see, the more I'm like, this is post-apocalyptic Mega Man before Mega Man X.
Alright, let's see if I can get Swordbot this time.
Hello, Mr. Justin Toner! Welcome aboard, this is Shatterhand from the NES, released in 1991 by Jalico. Pemmy, Justin T. 1977 is an old college buddy of mine.
Awesome. Hello. Nice to meet you, Justin. Ouch. My powerful robot hands cannot beat these normal human beings in a single punch, seemingly.
Okay, Alpha Beta Alpha will be give you sword, but Alpha Beta Beta is Ricobot.
Ricobot?
That ricochet. Ah. So, Ricobot. I guess you could say Ricobot is the one and only. That was Justin.
No, I misunderstood that at first as Ricobot.
Yeah, then that would have been Rico Suave.
Ooh, yeah, he has no range, but God, he beats the crap out of stuff like nobody's business.
Indeed.
All right.
Oh, he blocks shots!
That's actually pretty cool. Ooh, I do need that health.
I can imagine.
Alright. I like this weird, like, kind of instant shop things that are in here that either give me, like, power up my strength or give me energy.
Yeah, I'm kind of reminded of, as silly as this sounds, the vending machines from Borderlands.
Let's see.
As far as reputation goes, Justin, I think this is a B-tier NES game, but when you consider what's A-tier on the NES, that is not damning with faint praise. Okay, Fishy Finn thing tells us that Sword has the fastest attack speed.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Oh! Suddenly we're in a brawling game now.
Of course, you know, if you're gonna go around punching stuff, there's gotta be an elevator at some point.
Yep.
I don't know how I didn't get hit by those missiles a few minutes ago, but I will take it.
Okay, Beta Beta. Let's see, your options. Beta Beta Alpha will give you Pyrobot again. Beta 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 is Grenadebot.
Grenadebot's good. See, but I can't exactly get to any of those boxes right now.
True.
Ah,
so you know what your options are ahead of...
Darn it.
Maybe I should keep my big mouth shut.
No, I'm actually happy to know that, my options. Let's see. What? Let's see, Grenade Bot, and what was the other one?
Pyrobot.
Okay.
You've used Pyrobot before.
Yeah, I'll go with Grenade Bot.
And Grenade Bot!
I'm Grenade Man!
That felt good!
It was definitely one of my favorites in in 8 just because of how excited he was.
And one of the better voice acted ones, which isn't saying much.
Probably the sadly the best voice acted one is probably Swordman.
Though, yeah, I'll give you that.
Though that kind of gets ruined by the fact that I was going to say that gets kind of ruined by the fact that Mega Man then will pronounce sword phonetically.
I would give credit to Astro Man if I could understand half of what he was saying.
You've got flame sword. What? Let me guess. English wasn't the first language of these dubbed actors, was it?
Possibly not. Oh,
shoot.
According
Damn
to the fencing, the grenade bot can kill the missile launcher.
Can he? Oh, dang it. I didn't get the money. Whoa.
Okay, I guess we don't have a choice but to bust that thing up.
See ya!
Oh, where am I?
It scared me for a second because I thought I was going to go right into that one gear, and I was like, what am I supposed to do?
Oh, kidding!
Oh, those grenades, dang it. Oh, hey, I will take this. Hey, buddy.
And that
Oh!
Now you are the grenade bot!
I'm Grenade Man! I was unaware of this.
Ditto. Oh wait, here it is. Indeed, right here in the description on Wikipedia. If the player picks up the same combination twice in a row while still maintaining the robot, their character will combine with the robot and will have more powerful attacks for a limited period before reverting to standard form.
Nice.
And as I look back, you've obviously completed the area, so the period isn't nearly as limited as I was afraid it would be.
No, I completely demolished that boss with that. Because I wasn't even, like, losing life from his attack, so I just, like, alright.
Yes, Drax, I am a big Limited Run Games fan. I've got a bunch of stuff on order from them right now. Recently got in the Grandia collection and the two Blaster Master titles.
Nice. Inti Creates did a really good job with the Blaster Master games.
Oh, absolutely. And I probably would have gotten it eventually anyway, but I did double dip on the first one because Shantae.
Makes sense.
Yes, those who know me well, like Justin, will know that belly dancers are my kryptonite. They start performing and I lose all my powers.
An understandable weakness.
I did get Scott Pilgrim also.
I have had quite a few people commission me to draw belly dancers, so.
Yes, including eventually me, based on the art I showed you of last week, I think it was.
And I'm perfectly okay.
So that's a different style. That was Egyptian Saidi.
Well, being someone who likes hips, I can definitely say I have no problem with belly dancers.
Yes. Yes, I think Risky's Revenge is... I forget which one I'm missing after I ordered the bunch of them when the original Game Boy Color game went on sale for the Switch Unlimited Run. Let me check my phone real quick. That's got the orders on it.
I think I might stick with Grenade Bot. I'm really digging him.
So, let's see.
Though I might want to try Ricochet Bot at some point.
That's the original. Okay, good. I am getting Risky's Revenge. So the only one I'm missing for a physical edition is Pirate's Curse.
I like Pirate's Curse. I think that one was my favorite over all of them.